Well, this is Royal Blood Ministries. We're off to Glodick to share the gospel and Brother Mike has the new Royal Blood t-shirt on.
Hoodie.
He's got a hoodie. So, any thoughts about what God's been saying to you recently, bro?
I think God's saying to me, just go out there and tell people about Jesus Christ. No matter what happens, just preach Christ crucified and don't be ashamed of the gospel.
Amen.
It's the power of God into salvation, so just tell people about it. We're not expecting people to be overwhelmed with joy when we tell them, but we know it's the truth, so we're just going to preach it and be happy in doing so.
Amen. Amen.
Just one more thing. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it.
Amen. 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 I've got my Royal Blood t-shirt on as well, and we're off to Glodick to share the gospel. It's pouring with rain, but even if it's raining, if we can't preach because it's raining, we might just walk round and do some prayer and pray for the area. So this is Jason of Royal Blood Ministries signing out, and Mike, and have a lovely day. Keep praying for us, and keep us in prayer as we move forward and share the gospel in the United Kingdom, and hopefully we can do a few missions abroad. We've got a mission coming up in Wales in April, so if anybody's interested, let us know and pray for us. We need your prayer. So I'll just film it down here in a minute and we'll just have a chat about stuff. So have you been doing any studying on Islam recently, Paul? Any thoughts on Islam recently?
I've not looked at Islam, but what I have done is spoke to some Muslims over the phone.
We're going
to the Ahmadi Mosque.
Are we going to go to the mosque again? Yeah.
We are at some point, yeah. The reason I spoke to the Muslims is because I felt fired up about what happened in London recently with the town, with the Houses of Parliament.
Yeah, yeah.
And I just felt something inside me say, you know what? Enough's enough. We need to expose this religion for what it really is.
Yeah,
it's masquerading. That's not easy.
Yeah.
So yeah, we need to expose it. You know, there's a passage in the Bible that says, "You dress my wounds, my people, as if it were nothing, and you say peace, peace when peace is far away." So this is what I think these Muslims are doing. They're saying peace, peace, but there is no peace in Islam. Oh, there's no peace. Peace is only found at the cross, in Jesus Christ. That's where the real peace is. So it's a false kind of peace that we're promoting, and it's just not good enough. We need to tell them about the good news of Christ, and they need to come to the truth of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
We want to save them from eternity lost, so Jesus doesn't want to condemn them, and neither do I. I just want them to be saved and come to a knowledge of the truth, and that's what God desires. God desires truth in the inmost part, so I just desire, and I desire that as well for them.
Amen. Hey Mike, I just had a thought. What about putting to them about doing a forum?
Forum?
You know, like three of us and three of them in a room.
Yeah.
And invite the public and all the people like in Manchester and invite them. And then we just have a dialogue where, you know, they put questions to us and we put questions to them.
That sounds like a good idea. We'd have to we'd have to print off some leaflets for the public.
Yeah, 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 but if they agree to it, and we could use their hall as a venue. Mm. We could get the printing done and everything, and you know, it'd have to be like in a month in advance.
Yeah.
And then we could let people know and get someone to moderate it or something like that. And it's not a debate, but more of a like a discussion of, and then it gets our point across and gets their point. It looks good that Muslims and Christians are not fighting each other.
Yeah.
But at the same time, we can get the gospel across.
Oh yes, point the camera at the cross there. We have a church. There's a church. We're coming past the church now. The big cross on it. Praise the name of the Lord.
Yeah, this area here, I've done loads of mission round here in Newton Heath. Yeah, straight on.
There's a
church plant there, you know.
Is
there? Yeah, King's Church over there. Yeah.
There's another one near you, isn't there? I know it's doing some.
Watch this.
I think it's either a Pentecostal church or some kind of Bethel church or something around here.
Around here, yeah, there's a couple on here.
Is there?
Yeah.
There's one in Oldham, there's a big church in Oldham, and it's got a giant cross on the front, and I do drive past that sometimes in the van, and it just gives me great hope when I see that, when I'm having a a rubbish day. I'll see something I've got.
Yeah.
The cross just brings me home. I found a nice church up in Windsor. It's called the Broken Cross Church.
Where's that?
In Windsor, Cheshire. It's called the Broken Cross Church. I just want to tell people, if you're broken, just remember this: Jesus was broken on that cross for you.
There's
nothing in your life that Christ can't deal with.
Amen.
There's nothing.
Amen.
He'll take away your loneliness, he'll take away your fear, he'll take away your insecurity, he'll give you your identity, he'll give you meaning to your life. And
amen. Amen. He's a preacher and he don't know it.
What's that?
I said he's a preacher and he don't know it. He's preaching, isn't he? He's doing well. I taught him all that he knows. Amen. I tell you what, that noodle was rough, wasn't it? Did you ever, have you had one?
I've had one, yeah.
They're a bit rough, aren't they?
You've got to let it settle. What you've got to do, you put the hot water in, cover it for 2 minutes, stir it, and then cover it again. I think you just ate it off the buff, didn't you? Is it a bit hard? And
oh,
you've got
to
let the hot water permeate through it.
Oh,
they
man.
They were 50p, though, so you...
50p, man.
From Tesco's.
Amen.
I think what churches, what I'd love to see what churches to do is just to put some powerful gospel messages outside on a board, outside the church.
Yeah.
Rather than being a sleeping giant.
Yeah, like wishy-washy, like...
Yeah, come and have tea things. And cakes and let's have a messy church. Let's put that message on there from the board.
Yeah, put the gospel there. There was a guy who came to do a preach at a leaders meeting a few weeks ago up in Farnworth, and he said... It's not the gospel is Jesus Christ, and we should trust the gospel, the power, because it is the power of God, isn't it?
Yeah.
And it's not the gospel and plus coffee, or the gospel and plus being cool.
Yeah.
It's the gospel, and we try to like think that we can make the gospel, you know,
water it down.
Yeah, but it's the gospel itself that is the power.
Yeah.
And if we're just faithful, it will do its work. It'll restore and redeem sinners.
Amen.
You know, Paul said we preach Christ crucified, and you know, you just have to preach that simple, plain gospel that Christ was punished for our sin.
Yeah.
Because he loved us. God demonstrates his own love for us, that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us.
Amen. Amen. There's a Wesleyan chapel near me, and it's got Tai Chi for beginners on Wednesdays. You can go and do Tai Chi in a Wesleyan Chapel church.
Right.
Which I find quite bizarre, seeing as...
Yeah, well, is it, the thing is, you see, I went to the Nazarene conference.
Yeah.
Called Dirt to Dream, and they had some very trendy theologians there.
Yeah.
I enjoyed it. It was a real blessing. But they had some trendy theologians, and one of the couple, they had a couple of churches there that have been doing the work, and they were showing off the work, and they turned one church, they renovated it where it was a coffee shop, and it was good. People were coming in, they were doing ballerina dancing, and it was excellent in that getting to know people. But not once in that presentation did it talk about people getting saved. Not once did they talk about hell. It was all nice and coffee and great, and yeah, you're getting the relationships, and that's good. But the danger is watering the gospel down. You know, it's no good doing these friendship evangelism unless you're going to keep to the gospel.
Yeah.
And unfortunately, a lot of this like relational stuff, which is good, we need to show the love, seems to want to water down the gospel, which is wrong.
Yeah.
You know, that's what I think anyway. And history has a way of repeating itself.
Mm.
Because in the 1900s, they said, oh, let's turn the churches into soup kitchens and talk about God as Father.
Yeah.
But they won't talk about God as holy.
Mm.
They won't talk about sin.
Yeah.
And so the churches collapsed and became liberal.
Yeah.
Because really, it was a God of their own image, a gooey, lovey God.
Yeah.
But God... it's not just a loving God, he's a holy God.
Yeah.
And we can't like mould him into our image. So we have to be touchy-feely and caring and loving and relevant. But at the same time, God isn't moulded to our image. We have to stick to the true God of the Bible. And the God of the Bible is a God of judgment and holiness and love. And the gospel is that Christ was punished for our sin. How many times have you heard that Christ took the wrath that we deserve? How many times have you actually heard that preached? But that is the gospel. That should be preached regularly. But you don't hear that preached. You know, and if you don't hear that preached, what will happen is the church in the end becomes secular because it doesn't preach against sin. And then you get people coming into church, you get so-called saved, but they're not changed their lives. They'll be going to the pub, they'll be sleeping around, and yet they'll be worshipping and dancing up and down and enjoying the church service, but their lives aren't changed. And here's the point. If the Bible says in the Word of God, preach, it says by the foolishness of preaching.
Yeah, it does.
Right? If that is what the Bible actually says, how many churches actually obey that command?
Exactly, yeah.
How many pastors do you know that have come out and actually preached on the street?
Not many.
You know?
There's only one or two that'll do it.
Do you see what I'm getting at?
Yeah.
What I'm saying is that there is a secularising going on where we're picking and mixing, and we don't want the confrontational stuff.
Yeah, absolutely.
We want the nice stuff.
Yeah.
But you got to have the nice and the tough stuff as well, you know.
Exactly.
You know, and am I making sense?
Yeah.
You know, and
the thing is, love hurts. You see, Christ was bruised for our iniquities. He was chastened for our sins on the cross, and by his stripes we're healed.
Amen.
And you don't hear that at all. You know, you read about it, it's in the Word of God, but it's not so much preaching the church. It's the same. They tend to preach on the same themes. They tend to copy other churches, like, especially during Easter time, you know, talk about the passion and the walk to the cross. But, you know, they really need to get into the difficult doctrines of the Bible, the ones that aren't comfortable, you know, the ones that aren't that popular in the church, because the church is not here to be popular, it's here to preach the truth.
Amen, bro. Amen. That's the best thing I've heard you say all year, that mate.
Oh, thank you.
He's a preacher and he don't know it. Amen. But if we don't hold the line, this is really important, I think. If we don't hold the line in preaching the truth, that the church will become secular. And I believe that the evangelical church, and I love the church, but I believe that it's in danger of becoming secular. Because it's ministers. How many ministers do you know that have actually come out and said on national TV about gay marriage and said it's wrong? How many ministers in Manchester have you heard about it? How many ministers have you heard and said this is wrong? And say in the paper of Manchester Evening News that this is not biblical.
They don't.
How many?
None of them.
So if they're not speaking out the truth, no matter what they're doing, in the end they're just cotton wooling people.
Yeah.
In a cotton wool Christianity.
It's a tradition. They're following the traditions of the church, the traditions of men.
Yeah.
And they're not following the scripture of God. And I don't believe in interfaith either with Muslims. Like,
I've
seen churches in America where they've got Muslims and Christians worshipping together in the church.
Yeah, I don't agree with that. That's wrong.
And if you said to a Muslim, can we come in your mosque and preach Christianity? No. They will have no, they won't have it. So why should we have it?
Yeah.
So why should we? No. We preach Christ crucified, and if I was a minister of church, I would not let Islam into my church whatsoever, or any other religion.
Amen.
I'd say no, we're preaching the truth.
Yeah, there's only one truth, and that's Jesus Christ. He is the way, truth. I think we come off on the left, bro.
On the left, is it? This is familiar now. I've been around the family, so I remember.
I think
this.
We come off, if we come off on the left.
We're near Rochester, aren't we?
We can either go. We can either turn left and go down up to Wernham and then down that way, or we can go up this way here.
What do you think?
I think that go left is a bit easier.
Well, the word discovers our condition, doesn't it? Yeah. Word of God discovers our condition. The church just needs to, I don't know, I mean, the Church of England needs to be humble and say, you know what, let's just stick to what the Bible says.
Who cares what
the world thinks?
That's it. The Church of England needs to get back to the Bible.
Yeah, I don't believe in gay marriages. Yeah.
Quick.
Because the anointing won't be there.
Amen. It's like, got to be biblical.
Yeah. Women preachers, I don't really believe
in
that.
Where's that in the Bible?
It's nowhere. Paul says, I will not let a woman have to, a woman must be silent in submission.
It says an elder is to be a male, isn't it? When married to a woman.
That's right, a woman must not teach, and she must cover her head. A man doesn't cover his head because he is the head of Christ.
But
so Muslims, when Muslims wear those hats, they're dishonouring the head because...
Yeah, straight off.
Man's head of Christ is man. Sorry, the head of the man is Christ, sorry.
But do you see what I'm getting at, though? Is when you're talking there, you're talking because you believe the Bible and you don't want to pick and mix. You want to see what the Bible says and then you go for it.
Yeah.
Whereas a lot of evangelicals today, and we love the church and we want the church to be blessed, but they want to pick and mix. They want to pick bits they like and bits they don't like. They just leave out. Oh, don't talk about sin. Don't talk about hell. Don't talk about these things.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And
we should talk out. I mean... It's best to talk about because that's what Christ died for. Christ, he died for sin.
Yeah.
He didn't die so we could have a comfortable life. Yeah, we want a nice life. He wants us to bless us and give us a hope and a future. But he didn't bless us so that we could go and ignore sin. And, you know, we just need to get back to basics, basically. You know?
Basically, that's it.
Yeah, back to basics.
We need to get back to the basics.
Yeah, grassroots, you know.
You know.
People come up to me and say, what denomination are you? And I just, the question is just, it's irrelevant because at the end of the day, I want Jesus to say, well done, good and faithful servant, not well done, good and attendee of a Catholic church, or well done of the
Protestant
church.
I was listening to Francis Schaeffer, who I really love. He's a Presbyterian guy, but he was saying, and he's like Presbyterian, he was just saying it's about, you know, just being in Christ. You don't have to like sign up to all the dot. And a thing of a denomination is whether you're in Christ or not.
Yeah.
You know, so these are just things that we're talking about, brothers and sisters. Royal Blood Ministries, we're on a mission to serve the Lord today, and we're just having a little discussion about stuff on the camera, and hope you've been blessed by the discussion. Basically, what we're trying to say is, look, get back to the Bible, get back to the basics, and be fearless for the truth and stand up for the Lord in these days.
Yeah.
You need to stand up for what's right. Stand up for the Bible. Stand up for the Word of God and stop playing around with the Bible and picking the bits you like and leaving out the bits you don't like.
Be countercultural. Be unpopular with the world. Who cares?
Be countercultural. Stand up for the truth.
Yeah.
And you're not going to be popular, but at the end of the day, Jesus wasn't popular. So God bless you. Have a lovely day. One final word from you, bro, from Brother Mike.
Yeah, just study the Bible and believe every word it says, and don't try to fit it into a worldview. But remember, the kingdom of God is in opposition to what this world teaches. So just remember, the Bible is your direction. Jesus is your life. Amen.
Amen. I think one last thing. Tim Keller. I love Tim Keller. But I was reading the other day, Tim Keller was saying, and he's a big leader in evangelicalism in America, and he was saying that this evolution thing, there are four options. You can believe six-day creation, or you can believe in evolution and still be a Christian. And he was saying he believes in evolution, but he's still a Christian. And to me, this is just wishy-washy nonsense.
Yeah.
This is capitulating to the culture of the time.
Yeah.
Evolution, it does not make intellectual sense. The Bible clearly states that God created the world. He created Adam and Eve. Adam and Eve didn't evolve.
Yeah.
They were created by God. The human race was created by God.
Yeah.
So that's an example of how great leaders can be capitulating to culture rather than listening to what the Bible says.
Yeah.
So stand for what the Bible says. Hold on to truth. God bless you. Have a lovely day. And be praying for us. Take care now. God bless.
Amen. It's like culture changes and ideas change, but God doesn't change, does he? You know.
Amen. Amen.
Remember the 60s when it was all flower power and let's rebel and let's wear, let's smoke joints and let's get high. And
yeah.
Who cares about authority? And, you know, let's wear miniskirts and all that stuff.
Yeah, and look where that got us.
Yeah.
A lot of abortions.
Yeah.